Thank you. That concludes First Minister's questions. The next item of business is a debate on motion 13746 in the name of Martin Whitfield on behalf of the Standards, Procedures and Public Appointments Committee on Standing Order Rule Changes, Procedures on Consent in relation to UK Parliament Bills. I invite members who wish to speak to press their request to speak buttons, and I call on Martin Whitfield to speak to and move the motion on behalf of the Standards, Procedures and Public Appointments Committee. Up to 5 minutes, please.
I'm grateful, Presiding Officer, and can I extend my apologies to Cabinet Secretaries and Ministers who are awaiting appointment to bring before the Chamber the results of the fourth report from my committee, which leads to motion S6M13746, which I move in my name. The motion invites the Parliament to agree to changes to the standing order rules relating to legislative consent that clarifies the process in relation to instances where the Parliament is invited to withhold its consent. And can I thank my Deputy Convener, Ruth Maguire, for her support on this motion. Standing Order Chapter 9B currently provides for legislative consent motions to be lodged where the Scottish Parliament's consent is being sought. Both the Conveners Group and the Constitution Europe External Affairs and Culture Committee wrote to the Standard Procedures and Public Appointments Committee to highlight the lack of a provision in standing orders about motions refusing legislative consent. The correspondence highlighted the increased number of incidences in which motions refusing consent were being debated and agreed by the Parliament. Because such motions sit out with the legislative consent process set out in standing orders, motions refusing consent can be lodged and taken in chamber in advance of lead committees reporting on that legislative consent motion. In response to the concerns raised, the committee proposed a discrete procedure for refusing consent, which it consulted on with all the Scottish Parliament committees, the Parliamentary Bureau, the political parties, and indeed the Minister for Parliamentary Business on behalf of the Scottish Government. The consultation proposed a similar rule for motions refusing consent as currently exist for consent motions. This included the requirement that a motion refusing legislative consent can only be lodged if a corresponding consent memorandum has been lodged, and that the memorandum should include a draft motion. All the consultation responses were supportive to this change. The consultation asked whether respondents had a preference regarding lodging a motion mandatory. The majority of the responses stated that they supported placing an obligation on the Scottish Government to, quote, endeavour, unquote, to lodge a motion to give the Parliament the opportunity to refuse consent. The Minister for Parliamentary Business raised concerns that rules would operate in instances where UK bills may give rise to the consideration of different consent positions at different points in the bill's passage. So following these discussions, the committee has agreed that a single set of rules for any relevant bill, regardless of consent position, be proposed. The same process and stages are required, regardless of whether consent is being sought or indeed refusal of consent. The revised draft rules also incorporate the preference expressed in the consultation from the Scottish Government to try and lodge a motion on legislative consent. The draft rules use the term normally and do not specify any time limits. The committee believes the proposed rule changes will provide more clarity to the Parliament's procedures for considering legislative consent motions. The committee believes it will also provide a greater protection to the important scrutiny function performed by committees of legislative consent memorandum, and ensure the work of the committees on these matters is always able to inform the Parliament's decision taking on legislative consent motion. The rule changes themselves are set out in Annex B of the committee's report, and for the avoidance of doubt, the wording in the annex will completely replace the existing wording in standing orders relating to it. Due to the forthcoming UK general election on the 4th of July, that I'm no doubt we're all aware of, there are currently no UK Parliament bills on which legislative consent is being sought. This means that the motion is proposing that the rule change takes effect from the 2nd of July before any legislation which may seek legislative consent is introduced following the UK general election. I'm grateful, Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Mr Whitfield. That concludes the debate on standing order rule changes, procedures on consent in relation to UK Parliament bills.